Samsung jaw drops with the UH750. Because even though it's not a perfect monitor, like there is no perfect product, this thing is incredibly sharp and it will leave you saying, wow, like good God, this thing is incredibly tack sharp, looks amazing. It's a joy to play on, right? And I think that's important given the price point. So if you were somebody on Amazon right now looking at this thing and you're saying, why should I buy this? Well, here's why. This thing has quantum dot color, so for those who don't know, it's really vivid. Now, it's not as good as Samsung's highest end displays, but it definitely does a lot to give you that punch that you're looking for out of a QLED display. And I think that's so very important, and honestly, it was one of the main reasons why I personally bought this monitor. I say that because when you're looking at monitors today, they, for the most part, do not have quantum dot color. And the ones that do are so astronomically expensive, it's ridiculous. Now, by all means, if you're the person who can afford to run out and buy like the brand new mini LED monitors with like all the top specs, go right ahead. But I'm not one of those people, and I would imagine most people are not looking for all that. And this is a good everyday person's monitor. Now, the downside of this monitor is, and I'm gonna tell you, like an everyday person, right, is that it's a TN panel. Now, for those who don't do the technical mumbo jumbo, for the real world implications of that for you, what is that gonna do for you? What does it mean, right? The TN panel basically means that you have a 1 millisecond blazing fast response time for gaming. Yay, fantastic. However, your viewing angles are worse as a result. So just like TVs, when it comes to monitors, there's like a give and take and you have to sacrifice something, and the viewing angles are what you sacrifice here. However, fortunately, Samsung has created what they call the magic angle, and it basically, depending on how you're sitting, you can switch between different modes and it will accommodate for that angle. So that's really good. Now, traditionally, you would want something like an IPS screen or a VA screen in a monitor. Particularly, I tend to go towards a VA screen, if I'm being honest, because those are usually better on black levels. But typically speaking, IPS is the norm, and this is well above that as far as like the kind of contrast control that you're getting, albeit it's not fantastic. So you will run into gray blacks. I do not recommend you use this monitor in a dark room, though, because again, it's not like a local dimming display, and because it has no local dimming, blacks will look gray. And also because it's an LED monitor, and it's not like the top end mini LED monitors with all the bells and whistles for significantly more. Now, when we talk about this particular monitor, it's also important to understand that one of the biggest benefits of it is that it's a workhorse as well. So if you're not a gamer, you can do a picture-in-picture mode and you can enjoy the side-by-side operations for video editing or photo editing, and just task managing in general like is really easy with the new picture-in-picture mode that this thing has to offer. And I think, again, that's one of the huge benefits. Now, again, to get back to the negatives, this thing is only 60 hertz. So if you're that gamer that wants to use no V-Sync and you want upwards of 120 to 144 to 240 hertz, hey, good luck, because this monitor is not going to give you that. However, to be fair, it's a 4K monitor that supports 4K 60. So there aren't really any GPUs right now that can tackle 4K 60 rock solid without a single frame dip. So, you know, you take your victories, right? Again, you're not paying the top tier dollar amount, and you can't expect every feature. But if that's something that you really did look forward to with PC gaming, then this would be a good time to just keep looking for something else. However, if you're somebody that uses VSync on like I do, because you can use FastSync and a bunch of different other options, then this is a good option. It seriously is a great option to use. Now, I must specify something though. Obviously, another benefit of this is that it's a FreeSync monitor, and that's great. But again, if you don't have AMD GPUs, you're not able to take advantage of this. So if you have an NVIDIA GPU and you're just kind of winging it and hoping that it will work, currently right now, it will not work. You need to make sure that it is one of the certified G-Sync compatible displays, which right now LG is kind of running the domination in that field right now. But we have monitors, of course, but LG is really where you're going to go as far as that kind of thing, especially because of the price point. You know, they're coming out with a 48-inch OLED, and that's probably what most people are going to do for their G-Sync gaming things, and we'll see how that works. But for general everyday usage, for the everyday person, I mean, my dudes, I can't say enough. Do it. Like, stop thinking about it. Don't, like, be that person that's, like, reading too much into it. you're not paying the top dollar amount, and I'm not crapping on you by saying that. I'm saying that as a good thing. You're saving money. You're getting 4K res, you're getting quantum dot. That in the monitor is huge, and the black levels are better than most monitors out there. Now, another downside that I really hate is that you can't articulate it at all. It doesn't lean back, it doesn't swivel at all. It is a fixed screen. So if you're somebody that needs a swiveling screen, again, this is a time where you would look for something else. But I mean, it's still a good monitor. It still does a fantastic job. I mean, yeah, they have some more gimmicky game mode features and things like that, but I don't really care about all that stuff. Then they broadcast that there's a 300 nit brightness level, which, yeah, fantastic. Though in testing, I found it to be somewhere in the higher 200s. It would dip down in normal use after calibrating it. So, I mean, it's not really technically 300. You can reach that if you go for the most unrealistic, like really blown out bright modes, but most people probably won't do that. So I don't know that that's an accurate claim there. But overall, it's a good monitor. I can't speak enough for it. I think if you want it, it gets the thumbs up from me. If you have any questions about this monitor, just make sure you drop them in the comment section. I'll try to help you guys the best I can. But ultimately, even in 2020, this is a pretty badass monitor, and I say, give it a gander. Thanks for watching the number one brand in honesty, and until the next video.